What's up, people? People on YouTube? People on Twitch, almost? This is day 336, making Songbringer. Today I'm working on story. Story. Time. Finally, it's time to do some story. So I'm going to work on I'm going to start with the... We start with the sequence of images. This is going to be a cutscene where it plays a bunch of different images, and it's got some story in the background too. So, here's the story I wrote that's going to go with this. So, so that's today's goal. I'm just going to try and do like at least one visual scene, one graphic, and then just display all this text for now. And then eventually, this will turn into a lot of different graphics. There's like so many different visual scenes I want to draw. But anyways, what's up, Jonah and Teak? Yo, what's up, y'all? How you guys doing? So I'm gonna export this image. This is just something I just took straight from the internet. I haven't even touched it yet. I'm gonna go to save this in common. No. Backgrounds. Finishing your coursework? Awesome. Right on. Wait. So yeah, the only thing I've done to this image so far is I turned it into like a pixel art version. But I gotta touch it up or whatever. This is not at all the image. It will be... I want to turn this black background off first though. Zelton, what's up? Did you get your Steam key? Whoa. Oh. I'm like, why is it drawing black pixels? Is it 20% opacity? The new top hat kind of sucks now? What do you mean? What happened with it? Yeah, it bounces back every time it hits something. Yeah. Yep, it's supposed to. So what is it about that you don't like? Because I personally I'm really liking it myself. So yeah, tell me what it is about that. Like why is it that you don't like the bounce? How you like Stardew Valley, Zilton? Is it considering the mass of the enemies? No. You mean a female player? So Jonah, would be nice for it to at least get past a couple of small blobs. Oh, right. Oh, okay. I could do that. I think I got a one on my list already about this. It's not the top hat hitting a wall, but the top hat going further. There we go. Top hat should keep going, picking up multiple items. So also, let's see it this way. Also, the top hat shouldn't return until it has dealt enough damage. I think so. Basically, what that would do is make it so the top hat, if it killed, if it was just like it had a certain amount of damage it could do, like for example, four. And then if it hits a blob and it only takes away one of its damage and it still has three damage left, it keeps going until it deals all its damage. And that way you could hit a couple blobs at once. Yeah, it could be a blocking value. Oh, and also the type or top hat, improving that. Yeah. So that would be pretty easy because the hyper top hat, you could just give it more amount of damage. If once I get this system working here, I could just give the hyper top hat more damage. So it'll live longer, basically. It'll do more damage to more enemies. Good suggestion. Very good suggestion. I love when we talk about little things like this, because it really helps to get to, how to improve the game. There's, that's the thing. Whenever you have a gripe about something, or and there's something you don't quite like in a game or whatever, there's some hidden gem there, There's got to be something there where if you just tweak it a little bit or change something or maybe make it a little bit better. You find something amazing out of it. You're like, oh, now it's doing it for sure. For me, I got real annoyed when I was playing with the top hat and it didn't keep going at least to pick up multiple items, right? It like bounces back right when it hits an item. So I was like, no, it should at least keep going, pick up multiple items. So if there's a bunch of diamonds or whatever, you can just grab them all with your top hat. And that makes it more fun. It's fun to play. But I do love the way the top hat bounces off things because it makes the world feel like a lot more physical. So that's what I'm loving about the top hat. But solving this, I think, will help it feel better with enemies. It just properly deals damage. Okay, so we'll do some more of this. How big is this thing? 280. Maybe also reduce the damage the hat deals the further it travels. But that would make it bounce sooner. That would probably have the opposite effect. Maybe have it bounce if it hits an environment, trees, rocks, walls, etc. Yeah, that's my goal. So what I was thinking of that in my head when we were talking about it there. But basically, the way it already works right now is that It does bounce off things like trees and the environment because they have hit points as well. So because those things have a lot of hit points, the Hyper Top Hat would immediately bounce off of them because it would deal all its damage once it hit a pillar, for example. If it hits a pillar, it's a big old chunk of rock, it's going to have a ton of hit points, and it deals all its damage right there in that instant, so it has to bounce. But something like a blob that's a tiny enemy with only so many hit points, it's going to deal only part of its damage to that, so it would keep going. So that would work for that. That solution would solve all these... I think it would solve everything we're talking about here in the context of this conversation. Adon, what's up? Oh, you got the orb? Cool. Nice. Yeah, look at this. This is just about the right pixels, almost. Let's go 264. There we go. Oh, shit. There we go. Nice. All right. So cut this into a new layer. So we can turn that off. We just have the star. Make this like a note. I'm imagining this thing animated, like it just animates by doing this glow. Yeah, that would work. A little glow. Zilton, I haven't made this sun. I took an image of Rigel, or Rigel. I'm not sure how you say that star. Basically, I'm this star that you're gonna be near is called Bellatrix. It's in our Orion belt, and Bellatrix is a blue giant. So I took Rigel, which is also a blue giant. And because there's really no good images of Bellatrix, so this is a Rigel's so big that I can get an image of that. So this is just an image I got from like NASA or whatever, and I basically made it pixel art, and now I'm looking for a way to animate it or whatever. And I've got this text here. This is a story that I'm working on. This is the intro to the game. So basically, this story is written from Jib's perspective, and it explains how Jib wakes up. On Songbringer, doesn't know who he is, doesn't have any memory. Basically, he was turned off a long, long time ago, stowed somewhere on some spaceship, and because of his adventures or whatever. And Jib wakes up when Rock finds him. Rock finds him in this like disused broom closet or whatever. And Jib wakes up because he turns him on and doesn't remember his name, so Rock gives him the name Jib, basically. So before this, his name was not even Jib. And so Jib and Rock become friends and all that. But this is basically all I want to get all that across and get the context of the video game out. And so what I'm trying to do is I wrote this text or whatever, and I put this in the game today. It's like, this is going to be a cutscene. So there's going to be graphics or whatever like this. This will be one of the scenes or whatever. Imagine it only having this about that much frame though. So this is a zoom up shot. It'll zoom up from the bottom. And on the bottom of the screen, there'll be like some text, you know, there'll be the current line of dialogue or whatever. So I'm starting all that today. This will be cool. So when you start a game, it'll have this cutscene where it plays all these images and it reads through this story, basically gives you some context for these characters, who you are, where you're going, why, what's your purpose, why, who's Jib, who's Rock, what the heck is going on. What's the distribution of damage when hitting the environment? It's the same as it would be. E.g., when a blob is right next to a row of bushes, is the damage distributed evenly? No, it's distributed to what gets hurt first, most. So if you hit the blob, it does a little more damage to the blob and then does damage to things also in the environment. That's got to get better as well, actually. I'll put that in on the same note here because also distribute damage. I'm gonna make it so it when you distribute damage, so if your sword swing hits like four different things at once, I'm gonna make it so the damage is dealt based on how close you are to the center of the damage distributed. Based on how close. So if your sword swing just barely nicks an enemy, for example, and you're just like one pixel just hits the enemy, that's gonna do the smallest amount of damage it can. And if it's right there at the center of your sword swing, it's gonna do the most it can, and then distribute it that way. So it'll be a bit smarter. It should feel a bit better next time you play Songbringer. So it distributes damage better, and then the top half bounces better and all that. Adon, you're hoping to graduate early next year? Awesome! Yay! Can I check line 12 in the story? What do you mean? What about it? What's up, Zyger? Okay, so now I just need some stars. I've already got this star field and I'm gonna use that. Think I thought I had a star field. Maybe I don't. Oh, they're blurred. That's right. Now I want to go to the main image. Or the poster, one of these will do. Has some stars. And the planet, some stars and stuff. Let's disable this layer mask for a second, grab some stars. There we go. You're fixing it, super hyped about a pirate ship? Yeah, well that's kind of what they're about. This, you know, they're like adventurers or whatever, but they're also kind of they're not really pirates, but they say when on their ship on Songbringer, they say that we're about to lay anchor. So, that's what they do when they go and they get into the they're flying through space or whatever, and then when they get to a planet, that's when they lay anchor. So that's what they call it. Euphemistically. What's up, PMC? Yo. Merge these layers. They're party pirates, exactly. They're party pirates. They're pirates that like to party. Are you late? No, you're here right at the beginning, man. Oh yeah, the game's, man. Well, you haven't been here in a minute, but the game is coming along really well. It's getting to be I'm proud of it. I'm proud of what I'm doing with Songbringer. Why isn't this flip? Ah, there. Sweet. Now merge these. All right. Yeah, we got a star field and stuff. Yay! Is it just me, or the level one blob boss is harder than, say, the level five drop boss? Is it? Oh, you know what? Because there's a trick to it. You might not know the trick. But maybe I should look at that again. So I'll go. I'll check. Level one blob. You know what? I'm just gonna basically just say make the level basically the whole blob boss. Well, no, more like the level one to level six-ish blob boss a little easier. Spoilers. Spoilers? What do you mean spoilers? So if you're just joining the stream, I'm drawing Bellatrix. It's the star that Songbringer is going to be near at the beginning of the story. So today's goal is to establish some context with the video game. Who's the player? What's the hero's name? What's the little robot's name? Why are they doing what they're doing? Why is my cursor not drawing it the right color? Oh, because it's hue. Hue saturation. Damn, you know what? I hate it. I hate the hue saturation layers. I hate having these things. I'm getting rid of this right now. We need to duplicate that. Put that here and stuff. Merge these. And then merge these. There. You just hope the monsters look like they're dancing again? Nice. There. Oh man. I hate it when I draw the wrong layer. Damn it all. It's hard to see. There we go. Drawing to the wrong layer. Story of my life. What? What? Oh no. I ruined it. Somewhere along the line, I ruined this. I gotta go back. Damn it. There it is. All right, this is supposed to be 100. Merge that. That's 100. That's 100. Merge that. This one is a different color now. Get rid of this stupid hue saturation layer. There we go. Big AAA publishers don't get as much money as you might think. Really? Explain, please. What's up, Phenomenal Gaming? All right, now I can proceed to draw this again. Yep, so I'm working on some cutscenes here. I'm working on, this is the star Bellatrix. This is a blue giant star here in our Orion galaxy. And it's the star that Songbringer is near at the beginning of the game. So I'm drawing the stars as part of the cutscene. They only get 5% of the revenue as a profit. I would say that number's pretty average, yeah. Overhead's the reason? Man, I forgot how much I love art. I love doing art so much. It's so soothing. This is great. I love being in this phase of the game where I get to do some art. I get to do some cutscenes, establish some story. No spoiler alerts today, I promise. This is only stuff that goes in the very beginning of the game. So I guess, you know what? Yeah, I guess I should make a spoiler alert. If you don't want to even see the beginning story of the video game, the first 5 minutes of story that you see immediately on playing a game, if you don't want to see that, I honor that. I totally know what you mean. So you might not want to watch today's stream if you want to keep the story kind of for later. Yes, now we have a good looking star. Corona thing, and now we can set this to like 60% opacity. And so this is how this is going to animate. Whoop. Oh, not like that. So this is going to be a scene where you only see like the like about that much of the screen, and this will scroll, you know, upwards. This is what the camera is right here. This camera scrolls upwards until you're like this. And the whole time the camera is scrolling and everything, this corona thing is like getting like glowing like this. Dude, 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 dude. Yes, this is gonna look cool. Awesome. All right, we're ready to do this. This is good enough. I'm gonna put this in the game right now and start working on the story. Here's a story I wrote. Every single one of these lines will have like a basically a different image. But for now, today, all I want to do is get this single image in here and then get this story displaying. So basically, there's a passable context in the video game in one single day. I think I can get that done today. So let's save this all out. I don't need to name all these freaking layers. Naming layers, don't need that. So should I do, I guess I should do like stars. Nah, probably. Yeah, I'll do this as one layer. This is what all it needs. Okay, so this is going to be in raw, or no, sheets, backgrounds, Bellatrix. This is Bellatrix, just Bellatrix. And then this other layer here, this glow, this should be 100% black like this. Oh man, I gotta clean that up a little bit. Hold on. What's up, clock? Yo! Are there gonna be any black holes in Songbringer in the game? No, there hasn't been a plan for a black hole yet, but dude, that's a really good idea. Black holes are awesome. There's got to be some kind of black hole going, doing something in this plot. It's a 5-minute cutscene. Yeah, right. I know there's a lot of lines here, right? Stealthy Ninja Slice. Hello, what's up? Is this a new game or what? Yes, this is a new game. It's coming out this year. It's called Songbringer. Let me show you a little bit of it. Oh, I just repacked the background there, which we didn't need yet. But yeah, this is please ignore the text there. It says Flux Alpha 1.0. That's just some debug work I'm working on today. But this is the game. It's called Songbringer. You're this guy here with the sword. Your little friend there is a robot. The robot scans enemies when you kill them. Let's find some enemies. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Oh, this is the beginning of the game, so that's why there's not many enemies. This is the very, very starting area. You can throw your top hat. It's not like Zelda. Dude, it's just like Zelda 1. It's like Zelda 1, but it's procedurally generated. So the game generates a world every time you start the game based on 6 letters. So you give it 6 letters, and it generates your entire world based on those 6 letters. So if you ever want to play the same world twice, all you got to do is enter the same 6 letters when you start the game. If you want to share a world with a friend, you just give them those 6 letters, and they can play the exact same world. But other than that, it can feel like a totally different game every time you play it because the whole world is different. The items you find in the world are different. Everything is different, but it plays like a Zelda game. So there's a little introduction on Songbringer. Yeah, they do. They have to give a lot of cut to a lot more people than you'd think. Yeah. Right? Yeah, when Jib finds the item. What's up, DM John? Oh yeah, sorry, man. Yeah, I think you were one of the very first people to watch me stream. How you been, man? Sorry, I'm always online about this time now. So if you want to find me, I'm always online around this time of day. For me, this is like 2 to 4 p.m. I don't know what this is for you. Hopefully it's not too late or early. Okay, there. Now that edge looks better. All right, so I'm gonna export this bit as its own frame. We'll call this the Bellatrix Glow. Oops, I want Eps. Yeah, Bellatrix Glow. So now we got these two images ready to go, and now we'll get this text ready to go. And we'll start on this cutscene. All right, so there's the intro text. Last time I saw you was early December. Yeah, I know, I used to stream at night. What kind of date am I shooting for, or for the game? I don't have an official release date yet, but it's definitely going to be this year. Definitely this year, that's all I can tell you at this point. I want to make this game as awesome as I possibly can, so I'm trying to push the date as far as I possibly can, you know, like... But I know October and November is a really bad time to release a game, so I'm trying to get it done at least before that. It's a bad time to release a game for an indie. Whoa. Okay, so return all these new lines into space. Okay, so I'm gonna make this a string so we can read this and read this story off at the beginning. So we'll call this story. That would make it a story key. I guess it kind of is a story key, huh? Yeah, story, we'll call this intro one, I guess. Yeah, intro one. Yeah. Now that I have this body, I remember it like yesterday. So this is written from the perspective of Jib. So once again, this is a spoiler alert. I'm writing the story for the very first 5 minutes of the game. So this is something you play in the game, the very first 5 minutes. So I'm not really spoiling the game exactly, but I am doing story. So if you want to save this for later, you might not want to watch today's stream. Really? It's coming out next week? Oh, that's awesome. Oh, really? That's so great. I've been waiting to play Hyper Light Drifter for a long time. That's great. Also, Slain came out this week. If you haven't heard, Slain's out. Slain looks sweet. I backed that a long time ago. I'm a proud backer of Slain. That's right. HLD Hyper Light Drifter. Looks like super duper awesome. Check it out. Okay, so we got this text. We should have these two images exported, so let's get that packed up. And I'm gonna start this off. So I don't wanna skip the menu. No, wait, no, I wanna do a scene when I start a new game. It's getting awful reviews. What? Oh, damn it! I haven't played it yet. I hope it's not true, or I hope they fix it. Because visually, that game looks so awesome. And that's right, Teak, it can be fixed, right? All right, PMC. Okay, so I'm gonna skip. I'm gonna not skip the menu. I'm gonna skip to the menu though, because I want to start a new game and start off this cutscene. So yeah, this is how this will work. I'll choose a world seed. And then it should run this new intro scene. I'll go to my scenes. I've got intro layer, but I think intro 2 layer is what actually is the layer that needs to run. Is that right? Intro 2 layer. Yeah, it does this intro ship BG thing. And then it runs the title layer. We don't want to do that. We want to actually run the game. How I actually run the game again. Title layer. Teak, what's that? Did you change it? What? What are you talking about? Oh yeah, it's just game scene, create scene. Okay, so now we should be able to run run this scene. This is going to show a different graphic though. Oh, I gotta check my background's image. Backgrounds. Okay, this thing's getting to be 2048 by 2048. Which, yeah, I think that's gonna be okay. So we've got Bellatrix, and Bellatrix's glow in this image. I guess this will work. Keep it there. No, really, this should be in its own image. Yeah, this should be in its own thing. Okay, I put these in the wrong place. Bellatrix, Bellatrix glow, these should go in scenes. And then scene intro 2. We've already got a few other things I started mocking up here, but let's throw in these other two images. Bellatrix. Save that, close this. And then we can repack the textures now. It should repack both backgrounds and scene intro too. Okay, so I got these ready, but now I want to do, instead of this other ship background, I want to see Bellatrix. Bellatrix, stop ping. Put it right in the middle of the screen. Z0. Yep. And then this is going to be the glow. Bellatrix glow. Also center in the screen. This time Z1. And then we'll run a little action. So glow dot set opacity. No, we'll keep it at its normal opacity. Start, run action, sequence, create. Use this little ease function. To do a fade to over. I'm not exactly sure how long these should take. But we'll go from that to like 100 and, wait, what's a good, what are the good opacities for this? Looks like 100%, it's kind of blacking everything out around it. But it looks neat, it actually kind of looks cool that way. Looks like about there, 89% or so is about the top I want to go. And then 50% is about the lowest. So we start by fading into 90% of 255. What's that? 230. I'm your homework buddy. All right. What's up, homework buddy? Nice. Such an adult. Such an adult. Yeah, I think a lot of people do that on here on the stream. Lots of homework going on, huh? I'm just sitting here chatting and stuff. Okay, there. So we got this glow. Hopefully glowing. we need a... Oh, there's an intro duration and all that. How long is that? Okay, intro duration. Now let's just set this manually for a moment. Like... 6, 7. Let's do 10 seconds to start. You play Counter-Strike? Nice. Right? Yeah, textbooks. We don't want to go to the next scene automatically just yet. Okay, let's see if this works. We want intro 2 layer to be run after generate layer from the title scene. So create scene, let's see if there's anywhere else in here that, yeah, there's two places here. From calling the next scene. What's this? Oh, generate layer. Oh, okay. All right, so I can ignore this one, but the next one here where the generate layer is done, this is where it calls game run layer, intro 2 layer. So there, after the generate scene is done, it'll run this intro layer. So it only runs once. If you skip it, you never see it again. Until you start a new game. Annoying missions, it makes it better. What are the annoying missions in Counter-Strike? Yeah, better totally. We need better internet. A lot of us need better internet. My internet sucks lately. I can't upload at the same rate I used to last year doing all the streams and stuff. Okay, so I should be able to start a new game. Just do Seed Batman. I should run this scene after this generate layer here. Nice. We've got, oh, cool. We've got a, it didn't repeat. Didn't repeat the glow. We gotta turn off this flux alpha thing, render system. Did not mean for that to be checked in. Okay, so it worked, but it didn't all work. I want this thing to repeat its glow to start with. So sequence, this is a repeat forever. Let's see that again, I guess. There's some operations going on. There's some missions where you have to get tons of kills with the specific weapon. Oh. And on a map no one likes. Oh, man. Yeah, where's Bapu? I don't know. It looks cool with that glow. Alright, great. Next thing I want to do is see some text. So I wanna take this text here and get it to, you know, display all these lines while it's on that screen or whatever. So let's load the text. Anti-disestablishmentarianism, right? Are you learning about that right now in your book? That's a big ass word. Can't even get like a quarter of that word into the world scene. So I'm grabbing this from the localized strings, the what did I call this story? I think it's just intro one. Yeah, story intro one. Oh, this needs to be auto text. There we go. So we'll split this up into a vector of lines. I mean, a vector of strings called lines. Split text delim space 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 lines. Okay, so now for each one of these lines, first we need to create create label. We can connect words as long as we want. Yeah, you guys have some long words. 30 letters. Wow. Kit label. I'm not even going to do any glitching to this text. I just want it to be clear. Clean, easy to read. Node parent. Oh yeah, this. Font file, K font. Just K font. String's empty at first. Position is win size dot width times a half. Wait a minute, there's something else. There's some trick I got that if I finally figured out how to actually center text with Cocos 2DX. I'll figure it out later, I guess. And this is going to be win size. No. Yeah. No. Yeah. No. Whatever. Win size dot. Oh, no. This is need to be. Yeah. Win size dot height times a half minus something. We'll just do win size to height times a quarter for now. Anchor vec2 anchor middle. Z2. All right, now I'll do a loop. We'll loop over every one of the lines and we'll run an action. Run an action to like loop over every one of these lines of text and display it in the label. So for auto line in lines, okay, so we'll go, we needed to run an action that's delayed. So I guess we'll just go label.runAction. Sequence, or we could just schedule this. No, we'll run an action that delays. Sequence create delay time for how long is each line of text going to be? I guess we need to load the text first. And then we also need a const float duration per line. I think each line is probably gonna be around 10 seconds. We'll start with that. And then so the duration is going to be duration per line times lines.size. Schifffahrt controller smooten Sicherheitser if he cap free by Russian behorden bonus vermitter studio. Wow. Wow, you guys definitely win the award for the longest word ever. There you go. It's official. You've won this award. So we'll get a little counter going. Count equals 0. Count plus plus. Delay time, count times, k duration per line. Oops, I mean duration per line. Here's where we do a callback function. Call func create. Just takes void. Where we're gonna capture this label. Label pointer. Now label pointer. Oh, wait. Around this, we'll do a fade out. Of like a second. Actually, fade to is always more versatile. I always end up using it anyways. So fade out, fade back in. Zilton. Set string to like the current line. Oh yeah, and that's passed by value. And we also need a fade duration. Const float fade duration. And then this is going to be count times duration per line minus fade duration times 2. Okay, so hopefully now we'll have some text fading in and out. Slow. Why is that? Hey, there is a word on the screen. It says now. Now that. Why is it fading in so slow? Oh, it's fading in during the entire duration. Okay, so we need two kinds of fade durations. We got the regular fade duration, and then there's the text fade duration. And the text fade duration is used down here. And the fade duration is used here. So it split up the whole string into like, I split it wrong. There's something in NMs where it like loads dialogue and it splits it all up based on three letters. The three spaces, here it is. Oh, text replace. Oh, that's right. And then split up by new line. Oh, that's the ticket. That's the secret right there. No wonder it was so slow. Okay, text equals replace. All the three letters turn into new lines, and then we split the text based on the new line character. There we go. You can speak only in songs. Dodge Whale. Is Bellatrix a Harry Potter reference? No, it's not actually a Harry Potter reference. It's a reference to the star. Yeah. I know. Harry Potter got big, right? And they stole Bellatrix and a bunch of other things. I'm joking. Yeah. I'm really interested in the Orion Belt and the Orion stars out there. Bellatrix is one of the brightest stars in the Orion Belt. It's a blue giant star. So, you know, as you guys probably know, blue giants don't live the shortest of stars, so they can last like as few as 100 million years or whatever. Okay, here we go. We got some text finally. Let's see if this is actually reading through the text. We'll need to add some black background. Yeah, cool. It definitely needs a black background and it needs to scale upwards, so we're seeing the bottom of the star and then it scrolls towards the middle of the star. Okay. So we need some letterboxing to make it look cool. So there's some room for the text to be displayed, and that all fits and looks nicely. You visited Bellatrix in Elite Dangerous? Nice. What was it like? Tell me what it was like. Yes, Zilton, Jib was once a human. His mind was put into a robot. He put his own mind illegally into a robot, and he had many adventures after turning into a robot. And then eventually what happened is these something like happened to him. Either some bad people he was running with at the time basically just turned him off. He was Skybot. He was all cool one day. The next day he's turned off, and little does he know his memory's erased too. So when he finally wakes up in a broom closet aboard Songbringer thousands of years later, he has no recollection of even his name. So Rock gives him the name Jib. Is there a legal way to transfer your consciousness into a robot? No, there's no legal way to do that. You nearly burned your hull? Really? Is it that? That sounds like a cool game. Okay, so we need some letterboxing. Guess we would just put that above. Yeah, we just put the label at like level 9 or 10 or whatever. And then we'll put the glow and everything, and we'll put the letterboxing at level 9. Oh wait, but I want to scroll up above the oh yeah. So we want all the like content and stuff to go inside its own layer. Yeah, let's do a new layer. Don't even need to name it. Just keep it. All right, so let's call this layer Git layer. No, I don't even need, I don't want to do a layer color. I just want to do a layer. So that I can move content inside the layer and outside the layer, basically. Transhumanism. Plot twist. Rock gets sent back in time and puts his mind into Jib to aid him in the future so he can then travel back in time to put his mind in Jib. Oh, man. That's a great idea. Isn't it? This sounds a lot like the plot to that one movie where, what was his name? Who was the guy? I think it was. Where he goes back in time and then he's turns out to be himself or his own mother or his own father. He is his own father. He's a he and a she. You know what I'm talking about? Whatever. I'm on my way to the core of the Milky Way. Tides Numenera, huh? Well, let's check it out. What's this game called? Tides of Numenera. Ooh, is it a pirate game? Tell me it's a pirate game. Oh, wow, this looks beautiful. It's a fantasy game, huh? Dude, this looks awesome. Wow, this is some rad art. Fantastic art, man. Oh, I think I remember hearing about this one. Look at that. That's so gorgeous. Wow, cool. I gotta keep my eye on this game. Right, it's called the Grandfather Paradox, right? You mean every time travel movie, right? Right? That's why I really don't like time travel movies. I hate movies where they're going to try and change the past. Because it's always the same movie. Yeah, it's a spiritual successor to a 90s game called Planescape Torment. Oh, really? Planescape Torment. I don't think I've seen that one either. Or maybe I did, but I just haven't played it. Yeah, once again, look at their art. This is really good. So what kind of RPG is this new one, Tides of Numenera? This looks like a... I imagine this is kind of like not quite Diablo-esque, but like sort of more RPG party-based. What is this? Is that how it plays? Tell me how this actually plays and how it feels to play this game. Oh, that's right. I saw it on Kickstarter. Yeah, this game looks so amazing. You love time travel, but it has to be done right. Uh-huh. Back to the Future. Oh, the long word you typed before. It describes the agency that operates to sell the security certificates for ship ticket inspectors' hats. Wow, that's that long word. Wait, what was this other game? Elite Dangerous. That's it. Fatigue is playing. Sweet. I'm imagining this is kind of Wing Commander-esque. Or TIE Fighter, you know? You're flying around in a spaceship, mostly. Once again, look how amazing art is these days. So good. Whoa, look at that. Cool. It's awesome. Whoa. All right. You watch Edge of Tomorrow? Edge of Tomorrow actually was a rad time travel movie. I love that movie. They wrote a good plot for that movie, for sure. Edge of Tomorrow, I highly recommend that movie to anybody else, too. If you're looking for a good movie to watch, dude, that one's rad. DM John, it's been so long, I'm not sure that you're working on what you're working on anymore. Bosses, items, generation, what's the work list, the moment? Oh, it's, I'm mostly working on story right now for the next few days, but in general, lately I've been working on bosses, I've been working on new enemies, I've been working on making the world interactable, so let me show you a little bit. Zyanger, cool. No Man's Sky, then, is kind of the same concept as Elite Dangerous, then, huh? So this is a lot of what I've been working on lately, is, like, making stuff really interactable. See, I just killed that pillar of fire. And that one, too. Everything! You can touch, like, everything now. Your top hat can bounce off stuff, too. Like knock over skeletons. There's 3D stuff now too. So you can like sometimes you can find a room. We'll see if we can find a room with this kind of 3D. Oh, there's this too. These Verlocks. These things are rad. So these Verlocks, you have to kill every single one of the spiders before you can even hurt the Verlock. Oh, somehow it let that one little spider fall. But every Verloc has like a secret item. I already picked up the item for this level, but there would be an item right here. Elite Dangerous has every main known star planet with all correct data in the game and generates all their systems procedurally. Sweet. Wow. Okay, so Elite Dangerous was totally that concept. This is what I imagined No Man's Sky was original about, but I guess Elite Dangerous did it first, huh? You can't put out fire with fire, you didn't know? Oh no, Jonah, that's not intentional. I think I know what bug you had right there. I experienced the same bug. There's an item that I messed up on in the current version of the game, the shield. You're supposed to be able to get 3 levels of the shield, and I accidentally put the same item for every level, so you'll probably find a couple empty rooms in the current version of Songbringer, but it's not supposed to be that way at all. That Verloc room is supposed to always have a special new item, so I'll fix that bug, and then the next update, like, I'll probably do the next update next Wednesday, and yeah, that'll have that fix and everything. And also, I'll work a lot on the top hat too. That's really important to me. I'm really trying to dial the top hat in, so it feels right in the world, and yet still does some amazing things that make it fun. Like what we were just talking about. Really, Arcane. PMC, no way. Right? I don't know what it's supposed to be about. Wow, Teak. Yeah, that's crazy. I did not know Elite Dangerous was basically the same game as No Man's Sky almost. Wow. And what's the difference then? What's the difference between No Man's Sky and Elite Dangerous? Okay, so now this is gonna go as a child of Lair. Everything, not the label, that's right. So label will be this one or two. Glow is gonna be referenced based on Lair though, but everything is Z-Order. Oh, Z-Order Global, that's right. Got global Z-Ordering going on. Doesn't really matter. Oh wait, no, but I just want to change the position. That's right. So Z order. Yeah, okay. So this Z order needs to be 10 still. These can start at 0 and 1, and it really doesn't matter what layer Z order it is at all. So now we can add some letterboxing. Let's do a black layer color. We'll do 2 layer colors for the letterbox. Elite Dangerous is first person. I'm pretty sure No Man's Sky is both. I think it switches from first to third. I don't know. Wow. All right, on. We'll see ya. Good luck with your homework. Whoa, Elite Dangerous is 120 gigs? Whoa. Yeah, that's right. That's right. I forgot No Man's Sky has the generated life forms. So does Elite Dangerous have life forms and stuff too? I just did this letterboxing in a different flux thing. It's called not credits, not ending, not drink, not bite mount, save prompt. What was it? Cutscene? Is there a cutscene? Yeah, cutscene. There's some letterboxing. Don't type things twice. Never, never. Oh, Elite Dangerous is only 7 gigs? Oh, okay. I was gonna say to 120 gigs is a bit much, right? It's just a little bit much. I guess I don't even need to. Oh, yeah, get rid of these. All right, let's see if we even have an ang of have this even anywhere near right. Should have two letter boxes. Maybe. We'll see. Oh, you heard Elite Dangerous is going to be 120. Whoa. Oh, it's 23 in total. Well, okay. They're both too good to be true. Yeah. Silton, are you planning to release to the Wii U or 3DS? I don't have any actual plans for the Wii U or 3DS at this point, but I'm highly considering going with consoles and stuff like that at some point. So I will announce that soon. I'll make an announcement and say this is what is officially going to be happening with consoles with Songbringer. Oh, you're talking about Star Citizen. Oh. So man, is there a lot of games that are like that then? Which one's Star Citizen? There's a lot of these kinds of games right now, huh? And here I thought No Man's Sky was like this really unique. It was the only game of its kind, but it just seems like it's gotten the most most amount of attention amongst those kinds of games. Yeah, look, here's Star Citizen. Looks similar a little bit. Cool. This has good art too. Look at this. Nice. Wow. Dude, so many awesome games. Yeah, nothing's really unique these days, right? It's hard to come up with anything that you use unique, you know. There's a lot of similar games. But what's cool is usually when you play a game, usually a game is unique, even though it might be similar in ways to another game. It's got its uniqueness, you know. It's the most unique of them. It's procedurally generating almost everything. Yeah. And it's good. It is great art too, right? Don't make it for 3DS or Wii U. Nintendo's might release their new console this year. Yeah, they are. I think they're gonna do a new one. That's what I heard too. Why does Windows reinstall the driver for my joystick? 18 billion billion. Whoa. That's like 18 Googles. It's a you googly. Okay, it didn't work. There's no letterboxings. Where are thou letterboxes? And how do I get the fade layer just to move upwards? Why did these get game scene scene? No. Oh, this is game scene scene. We want to go this and put this above everything. No, wait, this is 9. Oh, it might be the camera mask too. Color black. Eighteen hexillion? What? Five facts about No Man's Sky. There will be a total of 18 bajillion jillion unique explorable planets. It would take 10 years to discover every planet if everyone on Earth discovered 500 planets per minute. Dang. Procedure generated solar systems, planets, flora, fauna, creature voyages, music, and spaceships. Most of its content using math functions as opposed to using storage space or the internet. Yeah, that part's so cool. It's so large that the development team built virtual probes to explore the cosmos and search for problems. Awesome! Having this whole black text and everything, but really it's not supposed to be black the whole damn screen. It's supposed to be just frame buffer size. Okay, this is taking too long to start the game like this every time, so I'm gonna go to the game. CPP. And change the initial scene. Wow. Okay, once again. Let's only do one of those. Whoa, that's so crazy, Teak. That's awesome. Your low red marker is the Earth. Wow. No Man's Sky is more focused on explorers. Oh. Okay, so it looks like we got a little bit of stuff below it, but it's above it. Here, this is a good idea. Just set the opacity to like 128 start. Specific point size. It's crazy. I have no clue why that's not right. So let's do scale 5.0 and put it like, I don't know. What the heck is the F piece? Oh, the frame buffer might not have a size yet. Or it might not have the proper size. That would make sense. Oh, and then this letterbox height, it's crazy. Let's see what frame buffer size is. Frame buffer doesn't even get created until the game is created, so that's probably why this has been failing the whole time. Frame buffer size. Yeah, it's huge. 2560 by 1600. That's so wrong. No wonder. Okay, I can fix this now. It's a huge commitment, huh? Yeah. I'll have to play for a couple weeks up to months before I can actually money back from the maps I created by exploring the universe, and I can't just jump in another ship to go hunt for pirates or go for trading. Wow. Right? I gotta get a drink of water real quick.
Russian. On the sides. Moroccan.
Okay, let's ignore the frame buffer size. Box height's going to be... dependent. We want the window size. So the design. The design res Y. Design res Y is tiny. It's like 240. The height of the screen we got is like 1600 or whatever. We want the ratio times something. So, const float box height is like, we want to multiply the ratio 2560. Okay, design res X over K design res Y. That'll give us the higher ratio and multiply that. No, this needs to be Y over X, and then multiply that by the actual width of the screen. So if our width is 2560 and our ratio becomes 1460. Yeah, that's it. Nice. That's the box height. And then that's all of that is wind size dot height minus this. And then multiply that by 50%. All right, I'm gonna see if I'm even in the ballpark here. They do have a lot of hype, right? These are big games, big games. It's going to be called Elite Sky Citizen. Nice. Box height. What do we get for box height? 11.49. I think that might actually be right. No. No. Oh, right, right. But the box height is smaller than the design res. Math, man, math. Oh, math. So we'll call this the, I don't know, the view height or whatever. Okay, design res Y minus something. That's 40. And then if I call this the view height, Elite Sky Citizen Bringer Craft. a Dyson sphere to keep out Earth scum. Oh. This might need to be 80. Then let's do both boxes. And I think these are good to go to put them up at full opacity now. Yeah, I'm glad the concepts are being explored too. There we go. That's kind of what I wanted to see. Letterboxing. Thank the good Lord. Okay, so now I want to get the text in the bottom of the box. And I make the whole thing zoom up on the star. Text in the box, that's all I want to do. Woo woo. So we'll put it at 0. Half the box height. Hype simulator? All it is a black screen? I'm wondering why that wasn't at the right Y. Maybe the box height's wrong. No, the box height couldn't be. It couldn't be what it is. Oh, that's better. Okay, cool. Let's make this all start to fade upwards and stuff, move. Okay, so we're gonna move the layer over, I guess over the entire duration. We'll move it very slowly and do like an ease exponential. So layer dot run action. All it does is move the layer, I guess. Yeah. Move by int create over the total duration, which is just duration. And the delta position. Now here's where we need movement. Vec2 movement is going to be 0 on the X. The movement on the Y is, I don't know. I'm just going to guess at first. 80 pixels total. So we're going to go layer.set position. Negative movement. And then move by int movement. Let's see if that worked. I want to see the star moving upwards. Unfinished maps. Microtransactions. Yeah, look. This is kind of what I want to see, but it's the opposite. I wanted the movement to be the other way around. Oh, wait. Movement 80, but then... Oh, that doesn't make sense. Let's do a little less duration per line. I'm thinking maybe 6 seconds instead of 10. And it needs I guess the text needs to like delay. It needs to delay before it does the text. I thought it was supposed, this looks like it's supposed to, from the math and everything, it looks like it's supposed to fade. That just immediately says, now that I have this buddy. Maybe it needs its opacity set to 0 first. Just immediately it says it. Close to that star. Yeah, this might be a little long, actually. This is like a good 5 minutes of... It's definitely a long amount of text. But, you know, that's probably what you want for an intro of a game this... kind of like this. So how many lines is this? 23 lines? Including the blank spaces, that's 23 lines times currently 6.2 seconds each. It's 104. It's like 2 minutes. Okay, it's only 2 minutes long. That's all right. You have to fly into the Corona to refuel? Sweet. All right, so how long have we been streaming today? 2 hours, just about. Yeah, so I guess I'm going to wrap it up here. So, yeah, today's goal was to get this intro cutscene started. And this is a good start so far. I've got one scene, one drawing ready for this. But there's going to be about 16 or so different graphics here. And it's going to be displaying this story underneath and showing all these cool cutscenes. And then this is the beginning of the game. It introduces you to basically Songbringer, what the ship's about, the characters aboard it, and things like that, what your purpose is, all those things. So I say I'm gonna give this a good week or two. I'm gonna keep on drawing more images and stuff and make this really awesome. So this has a really cool intro for the game, and it'll help establish context for you as a player. You'll know, you know, who you are, who's the hero of the game and all that. So my next steps in this today are gonna be first of all, work on this scene right here so it doesn't, you know, it looks a little bit better. But secondly, start drawing more images. I need to, like, make this a cool system so I can have more images, and each image might have a little bit of, like, a glow or a different sprite and stuff like that. I need to represent that with data correctly and then, you know, cycle through these images as we're doing this intro cutscene and stuff. And so there's a lot of work left to do, but this is a good start. Would it not be better to give them the briefest bit of story and make them learn the story through the game? Well, yeah, DM John, that's true, but you have to have enough context at the very beginning that it answers most of the questions that you need. But yes, the bulk of the story will be through the game. There'll be so much more story than just this, man. This is just the intro. Where you gather aliens from stars. Crazy. Well, anyways, so that's it for today's stream, and hope you guys have a good night. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.